Hey everyone, Rox Original here. So if you want to see how I made this into that, then stay tuned. So today we're going to be making a three-sided river table. It's going to be a coffee table. So I've just tidied it all up now. I've dug all the bark inclusions out. I'm just squaring it up now to measure up for into the form. I'm using complete sacrificial wood for the form. So the form's cost me nothing. It's all made from scrap wood, as you will see. Probably my worst form ever made, but it's about keeping them costs down at the end of the day. So I'm just getting it all marked up now, getting it into the form. I've actually had to cut another piece of oak, what's in the corner there, off of another slab to go with this one. It's pretty much a match from the same I think it was off of the same tree, off another slab that I had. This little piece of oak here was not very desirable. It was very unusual sort of slab. So I had the idea in mind to do the three-sided river table with the little bit in the middle. And I must say, I changed this literally three or four times. So I had no idea at the moment where I was exactly going with it. And you'll see how many times it changes. And now just have a look now. Come on, get it in the form now. Assemble it and then pour the black epoxy in it. So we've got this bad boy clamped up. Stop some epoxy and just drip it in. We're good. Right, so I'm gonna add some of this glitter in. Alright. I just hate using it, it's so messy. I'm just gonna try a little bit to make it look a bit electrified if I can. Yeah, this would have looked so cool just by itself with clear epoxy poured all over this. I am actually gonna use this effect, this exact effect, in a future build of my dining table that I'm going to be making for my front room open plan kitchen. So look out for that one, and that is going to be a really cool build. Can't wait for that. So I'm just going to show you what the materials we're going to be using. So to start off, we've got coffee beans, various different colored sprays, metallics, potch opal, wood chippings, polished river pebbles, metallic pens, acrylics, shells, tropical shells, paint, glitter, fish, starfish, unpolished pebbles, slate, dragon rock, pine cones, mini shells. All right, let's crack on. first. That tells me you're all good. Another bit here, I'll get this bit. Go over it. Put the glitter again. And also, put some of this in it. That's all we need. We'll do this fine. Right, so it's the next day, and coming, it's lovely and clear. Got a few bubbles. Well, I knew that was going to happen because it was only like the second pour. So we've got some there, some over there, which is minor. Just squirt the alcohol in it, and you'll be able to see that when you pour the epoxy, if it's going to disappear or not. And this is still showing some white marks, so we'll go back in again. Move on to the next. Well, I have to say, this is coming along very nicely. Let's start with the gash, mini gash. Oh, I feel I've only got away with it, you know. God, I'm relieved. Alright, so quick recap. This is ready to demold, but what I've done is when I put this in, I put it on top of the epoxy because I've done it as an afterthought. So it's slightly like a mil or two up. So rather than having to pour more epoxy over the whole top, I just put a ratchet stead on it. Just done this top bit. What I'll do now, I'll just sand that flat. Put the black back in it up to match that. I'll put the black in the grey, remember? And then I'll just sand that bit, and then I'll start doing the first few of the flood coats over the next few days. Bit tougher that one. It's all right though. Come off nice. Yeah, look at that. I do have to work my way around. Oh yeah, the one bit that ain't square is here, and that's why I drew the line across there. So I only got to trim it once. It's one cut. There you go. Ready for trimming up. So I've trimmed it up, sanded it. Not to any, I'm hoping to put the epoxy on it tonight. So I remember I said I routed that. Remember I flattened that down, so I've got that black in the grain again. Yeah, so we're ready. I'm gonna give it a quick wipe with the alcohol, as you should do before every pour. So over the next 5 days, I repeated this process. I've done 3 flood coats over the 5 days. I've done a rock faced edge on it and then sanded and polished it. But unfortunately, I lost that footage because it was in another segment and it just got lost in the iCloud. So we'll have to take it from the up.
Don't you mess around with me.